Hi everyone, my name is Ravi Prakash and welcome to second part of Boards and Streams. Okay, so we'll start with this question here. A boatman rows for 3 hours downstream and then for 3 hours upstream. In this whole process, he covers a total distance of 12 kilometers. So if the speed of his stream is 1 kilometer per hour, for how much more time he will have to row upstream to reach the starting point? Okay, so start with C. Now get the concept here. A boatman rows for 3 hours downstream and then for 3 hours upstream, right? That means suppose he's going from point A to B. Okay, so if he's going from point A to B, so if he drives for same time, right? He has rowed for 3 hours downstream. Okay. And again, 3 hours upstream, right? So first thing, the logic here is, while going like this is downstream, this is upstream. While going upstream, in 3 hours for the same time, he cannot cover the whole distance. Logical, right? Because in downstream, in going downstream, the speed of boat is more. So if he has drive, if he rows the boat at some speed, right? In downstream, it is faster. So in 3 hours, in downstream, it will cover more distance. And while coming upstream, the boat is now slower. So in 3 hours, it will cover lesser distance as compared to the distance which he covered in downstream. Okay, that means boat will not completely reach to A in 3 hours, right? Okay, so let's say boat reaches a point C here. Okay, in 3 hours. Now he has covered a total distance of 12 kilometers, right? That means I can write here that distance downstream plus distance upstream is how much? 12 kilometer. Okay. What is distance? Is speed into time, right? Distance is speed into time. So what is downstream speed? Now you can see here that speed of stream is 1 kilometer per hour. Okay. So if speed of stream is 1 kilometer per hour, so distance is speed into time. Time is 3 hours. So for 3 hours into SB plus SR, and SR is given as 1. So into SB plus 1 plus again upstream. Stream is also for 3 hours. For 3 hours, SB minus SR, so SB minus 1 is equal to 12 kilometer, right? And just for understanding, I'm writing arbitrary SB here, right? You can take X, that S and B. Writing two variables will take more time. Okay, writing one variable will take less time. So calculate for X actually. Okay, so 3 into, you can see here 3SB plus 3 plus 3SB minus 3. Okay, 3SB minus 3 is equal to 12 kilometer, right? Minus 3 plus 3 will get cancelled. Therefore, SB you got as 2 kilometer per hour. And SR is already given as 1 kilometer per hour. That means, speed of current is 1 kilometer per hour. And speed of boat in still water is how much? 2 kilometer per hour. That is the actual speed of boat is how much? 2 kilometer per hour in still water. Okay, so in 3 hours, how much boat will go? So see here, if downstream speed is how much now? So now SD becomes 2 plus 1, 3 kilometer per hour, and SU becomes 2 minus 1. SD becomes 2 plus 1, 3 kilometer per hour. SU becomes SB minus SR, 2 minus 1, 1 kilometer per hour. Okay, so in downstream speed, if he drove for 3 hours, so 3 into 3, he will cover 9 kilometer total. He will cover 9 kilometer in total. Okay. Upstream speed is 1 kilometer per hour and he rows for 3 hours, right? So in 3 hours, he will cover 3 kilometer. He will cover 3 kilometer from here to here, right? That means further he has 6 kilometer to go. And what is the upstream speed? It is 1 kilometer per hour. Therefore, he has to cover 6 kilometer at the speed of 1 kilometer per hour. So what is the speed? So required speed would be how much? 6 kilometer per hour. He has to cover 6 kilometer. Okay. So he has to cover 6 kilometer at the speed of 1 kilometer per hour. Right? At the speed of 1 kilometer per hour. Okay. So what is the answer? Answer is required speed is what? It is 6 km per hour. It is 6 km per hour. Correct? Okay. Now move to next question. A boat travels from city A to city B upstream and returns from city B to city A downstream. Okay. If the speed of the boat in still water is 100 meter per second and the speed of a stream is 20 meter per second, what is the average speed of the round trip? Quite easy this question, right? So what is the average speed here? So if the speed of boat in still water is 100 meter per second, okay, so that means SB is given as 100 meter per second and SR is given as 20 meter per second. What is the upstream speed? SB minus SR. 100 minus 20, that is 80 meter per second. What is downstream speed? SB plus SR. 100 plus 20, it is 120 meter per second. That's it. Okay. So now he is covering the same distance. So it is given that it is required is for the round trip. Round trip means going from A to B. Okay. Going from A to B and then coming back from B to A. Total round trip, complete round trip. Okay. So, going and coming back the same distance, right? Directly I can apply funda for average speed. We have studied this. What is average speed of two when it is like going at the speed of A kilometer per hour and coming at the speed of B kilometer per hour? What is the average speed? It is 2AB upon A plus B, right? That is 2 into 100 into 20 upon, 2AB, no? 2 into 80, speeds are what? Speeds are 80 and 120. Okay, 2 into 80 into 120 upon 80 plus 120. You'll get answer as 96 meter per second. This is the answer for this question. Okay, quite simple. Average speed, going back, coming back, same distance. Harmonic mean of the two distance, of the two speeds, 2AB by A plus B. We've discussed this concept so many times. Okay, move to next question now. Move to next question. A ship of length 600 meter is moving. Now, this is a bit good question, right? It's a good question now. A ship of length 600 meter is moving upstream in the river and crosses a boat floating freely on the stream. Okay, so see here. The situation is the river. Suppose river is flowing like this. There's a big ship. Okay, there's a big ship of length 600 meters, the length of ship. Okay, now it crosses a boat, right? Length of boat is not given, that means the boat is negligible, very small boat. Okay, so obviously, boat is now floating freely with the stream, and ship is going upstream. That means if river is flowing like this, ship is going like this upstream. And boat is also coming like this. It is coming with the river. Okay. So, speed of stream is 10 meter per second, right? Let the boat of speed of boat is SB. Okay. Or I have two things here. Okay. So, I'll assume here. I'll not assume only SB. Okay. Let's assume a speed of ship as SSH and this speed of boat as SB. Okay. Now, since it is flowing with the river, it's quite easy, right? What is SB? It is 10 meter per second because it is flowing with the river, because SR is also 10 meter per second. So SB also becomes 10 meter per second because this is small boat is flowing with the river. Right? It is given that it is floating freely on the stream. That means with the speed of current, floating freely with the stream. Okay. So now what is the relative, right? So now this ship is here and this boat is here, right? They're coming from opposite directions. Okay. So what is first downstream speed of speed? Upstream speed of boat, ship. Okay, sorry. So what is upstream speed of ship? It is speed of ship minus speed of river, right? SB minus SR, right? So speed of ship minus speed of river. What is speed of ship here? Let's say SSH minus speed of river, that is 10. Minus speed of river, that is 10. So this is going. So let it be, let the speed of ship be X. So this is going with a speed of X minus 10 meter per second. Okay, let the speed of ship be x meter per second. Okay, so this ship is going at the rate of x minus 10 meter per second. Boat is coming from opposite side at the rate of 10 meter per second. The ship is going at the rate of x minus 10 meter per second, and up from opposite side boat is coming at the speed of 10 meter per second. What is the relative speed? So relative speed of ship with respect to boat is how much? Boat is coming with a speed of 10 meter per second. Ship is coming with a speed of x minus 10 meter per second in a opposite direction. So obviously speed will get added. So x minus 10 plus 10. That is equal to again x meter per second. It's equal to again x meter per second, right? That means relative speed of ship with respect to boat is the actual speed of ship. That is x meter per second. Correct. So in how much time the ship will cross the boat? Okay. So now time is distance upon speed. Okay. How much time it will take? So it's just have to find, right? So time is distance upon speed. Okay. Time is given, no? Time is given. It will cross the boat completely in 45 seconds. Okay. So because of its length, right? So when point is like this, so because of length, ship will take 45 seconds to cross the boat. Okay. So time is given as 45 seconds. So I'll put time as 45 seconds. Distance. What is distance covered? Okay. The distance is the length of ship. That is 600 meter. Length of boat is not given. That means it is negligible. Okay. So distance have to cover to cross the boat in 600 meter upon speed. Now this is relative speed of speed and boat. Sorry. Relative speed of ship and boat. It is how much? It got to ultimately x. So x. Okay. Therefore you see x is how much? 8 meter per second. Therefore speed of ship is 8 meter per second. This is the answer for this question. It's a very nice question, right? Good question. Okay. Concept of a relative speed with boats and ships. Okay, very nice question it is. Okay, now move to next question. Okay, this is the next question here. A very good question. It's a very good question. Okay. A river is flowing downstream at 30 km per hour relative to the shore. A rafting team is on a raft and at first they row upstream and can go only 3 km per hour relative to the shore. A man at the back of the raft is wearing a hat when they begin, but after 10 minutes, his hat falls into the water and floats. And it is 15 minutes since it has fallen before they notice it. They then instantaneously reverse direction and row back to catch up with the hat, rowing with the same strength and power which they were rowing before. Okay, so in how much time they will catch the hat, right? So it's a really good question. Combination of boats and streams with relative speed. Okay, let's solve it now. See, so it is given that a river is flowing downstream at 30 km per hour relative to the shore. That means speed of river is actually 30 km per hour. Speed of river is 30 km per hour, right? Why? Because, see, shore is what? Shore is an stationary object, right? The shore is an stationary place, right? What is shore? For sea, beach is the shore. Okay, so at beach is always stationary, right? Beach is not moving, no? So beach is stationary. So whatever is the speed with respect to an stationary object, right, that speed is actual. For example, if I'm standing on the road, okay, simply standing, I'm not moving, and I watch a car, that car is going at a speed of 60 km per hour. That means actual speed of car is 60 km per hour, right? I'm not moving, so I'm stationary. So whatever is the speed of the other object with respect to an stationary object, that speed is the actual speed of that object, right? Actual speed. So with respect to a shore, that is stationary. River is flowing at the rate of 30 km per hour. That means this is the actual speed of the river. That is 30 km per hour. Okay. Now, a rafting team is on a raft and at first they row upstream and they can go only 3 km per hour relative to the shore. So you think here that upstream speed for shore is 3 km per hour of the boat, right? Because when boat is going 3 km per hour, okay, very slow. 3 km per hour is very slow because the speed of river is what? It is 30. So boat is going very slow upstream because it is going against the river, okay, at 3 km/h. That means it is going upstream and it is priori is pushing him back, right? River is pushing the boat back, but boat is coming at three kilometer per hour, right? So that means what is the actual speed of boat? So actual speed of boat is what? It should be 30 + 3, that is 33 km/h. This should be the actual speed of the boat. Okay. Formula so you can apply simple. SB, what is SB? What is SU? SU is SB minus SR. Therefore, what is SB? SU plus SR, 33. So I got actual speed of boat as 33, right? So see, this is a river here. Suppose this is a river flowing at certain speed, right? This is a boat. Boat is going in against direction, right? Now, speed of boat is actually 33. And river is flowing at the rate of 30 km/h. That is the speed of river, right? 30 km/h. And now, hat is fallen. And so, obviously, hat will flow along with the river, right? Hat will flow along with the river. So, hat will flow like this. And speed of hat will be actually 30 km/h. That is the speed of current or speed of river itself, right? 30 km/h is the speed of hat. Fine. So now they've given that, but after 10 minutes his hat falls into the water and floats, and it is 15 minutes since it has fallen before they notice it, right? A man at the back of the raft is wearing a hat when they begin, but after 10 minutes his hat falls into the water and floats, and it is 15 minutes since it has fallen before they notice it. This is my main concern, right? 15 minutes. I don't have to do anything with this data of 10 minutes, right? Why? Because I just need the relative distance between boat and the hat. Okay. So since it has since it is 15 minutes, it has fallen before they notice it, right? So I just have to see that in 15 minutes, what is the relative distance between boat and hat when they notice it, right? Because that is a distance they will catch, because then the boat will turn back and they will catch the hat. So when they notice it, boat is going like this, hat is going like this. So when they notice it on the boat, when they notice it, hat has, it has been since 15 minutes when hat is fallen. What is that distance? What is that distance, right? So I should write here relative distance. Relative distance between boat and hat. Okay, boat and hat. When they noticed it is how much is equal to, distance is always speed into time. Okay, so boat is time is how much? 15 by 60 hours. In hours, 15 by 60 into speed, time into speed. What is the speed? So boat is actually going upstream at the speed of what? So actual speed of boat is 33. And actual speed of river is 30. So how much is boat going? So boat is going actually upstream speed of boat is how much? So upstream speed of boat is how much? It is 33 minus 30, 3 km/h. So boat is going in this direction at the rate of 3 km/h. Okay. And hat is going in this at the rate of 30 km/h. So what is the relative speed? So when two bodies are going in opposite direction, we simply add. That is the relative speed, right? That is 3 + 30 km/h. That is 33 by 4 kilometer. So it is how much? It is 33 by 4 kilometer. Okay. So now boat turns back, and now time taken to catch the hat. Now time required is how much now? What is time required? Time taken to catch the hat. So now boat turns direction. Okay. Now boat simply turns direction. So when boat turns direction, boat will go at the speed of 63 km/h. Right? Why 63? Because 33 is the speed of boat and 30 is the speed of river. So boat is now going at the speed of 63 km/h. Hat is at a distance of 33 by 4 km from the boat. And how much time it will take? So time is what? Distance by speed. So when bodies are moving, it is always distance by relative speed. What is distance here? 33 by 4 kilometer. What is relative speed? So now two are going in same direction, right? Boat is coming with 63, hat is going with
30.
So in same direction, speed gets subtracted. That is the relative speed. Okay, that is 63 minus 30. Okay, kilometer per hour. What is the answer? So answer is 33 by 4 by 30. Answer is 1 by 4 hour. That is 15 minutes. So 15 minutes is the answer for this beautiful question. 15 minutes. Very good question. It is very, very good question, right? So I hope you got it. First thing was, a speed of river is 30 km per hour given. Upstream speed is 3 km per hour. So you got the speed of boat as 33. Why? Because SU is SB minus SR. Okay, so speed of boat is what? 33 km per hour. Now, so boat is going upstream actually with a speed of 3, 33 minus 30, and hat is going with 33. So since it has been since 15 minutes, right, it has fallen before they noticed it. So that means this 10 minutes is of no use to me. Okay, only this 15 minutes, right? Because I just have to calculate what is the relative distance between boat and hat when they noticed it, because that is the distance they need to catch up. Okay, so boat, when the hat fall, so boat is going like this, hat is going like this. Okay, so what is the relative distance? So since it has been 15 minutes before they notice it, right? So in 15 minutes, boat will go how much? Hat will go how much, right? So what is their relative distance? Okay, so boat is going at the speed of 3, hat is going at the speed of 30. So distance is what is speed into time, so time into speed. So it is 33 by 4 kilometer. So time required to catch it is how much? 15 minutes. Okay, so very good question, very nice concept. Okay, well explained also. Okay, thank you. We'll see the other question in the next videos.